Greetings everyone, today I'm going to introduce you FLUX.1 Kontext DEV model, which is an image editing model like the ChatGPT image editing that went viral worldwide. You will be able to use this model locally and change any image as you wish with just natural prompting. You see, I have converted this image into famous Ghibli style, which went viral. I have outpainted this image like this. I have used these two images and regenerated them in a new scene with excellent accuracy and resemblance, as you are seeing, from these two images into this image. I have converted my image into anime style. I have changed the hair color of my image. So pretty much everything is possible with this model with just natural prompting. And to prepare this tutorial, I did a lot of experimentation and testing. I did a lot of grid testing, tested different parameters, tested different prompts and settings, so that in this video I can show you how to use this model accurately. And it is running in SwarmUI, so you are not going to spend your time with spaghetti ComfyUI. However, SwarmUI is utilizing the ComfyUI as a backend. Therefore, we are going to get all of the advantages, all of the features of the ComfyUI, but with such simplicity to use. So in this tutorial, I will show you how to one click this model, how to download the presets and apply them, like reset params to default and just apply the preset and right away use it. Moreover, I have prepared FLUX Kontext prompts so that you can use this file to learn how to prompt this model. So how you will be able to use this model? The link of this post will be in the description of the video. If you don't know how to install SwarmUI with ComfyUI, please watch this tutorial. The link will be also in the description of the video. So first of all, download the latest SwarmUI model downloader zip file. Click here, it will download it. I also recommend you to read this post. You will see the updates I have made historically. For example, this is the update we made today. Then move the zip file into your installation folder. Right click, extract all, like this. Then overwrite all of the files with the new files, replace them. Then click Windows Start Download Models App.bat file. More info run anyway. This will start the model downloader where we will download the FLUX Kontext DEV model. This is our model downloader interface. It supports so many models. Also, we have so many tutorials that you can watch. I have added the FLUX Kontext DEV into our bundle, which bundle into our FLUX Models Download bundle. So you can download FLUX Models bundle. It will download all these models. Or if you only want to download FLUX Kontext DEV model, go to Image Generation Models, go to FLUX Models, and you can use FLUX Kontext DEV FP16. Alternatively, I also added FLUX Kontext DEV GGUF, Q8, Q6, Q5 and Q4 models if you want to use them. But with SwarmUI block swapping, it is already working amazing for me. So I didn't need it to use these GGUF models, but it is up to your choice. If you want it to fully fit into your GPU VRAM, you can use any of them. So let's click FLUX Kontext DEV download. Since I already have this model, you see it is already downloaded. Then this is crucial. You need to update your SwarmUI and also your ComfyUI installation. Normally SwarmUI automatically updates, but since I am using our manual ComfyUI installation, why shouldn't I update manually? So I will also update manually from here, Windows update ComfyUI.bat file. When you watch the tutorial that I have shown you, which is in the post, you will learn how to install all of this. Okay, let's continue. So the ComfyUI was updated. Let's also update and start SwarmUI from here, Windows update SwarmUI, more info run anyway. And it will update SwarmUI to the latest version. This will not break anything that you have. Okay, it is updated and started. Then first of all, I recommend to import the newest presets. So click import presets, choose file, go back to your installation folder, and you see there is amazing SwarmUI presets version 3. Double click, override, import, and it will import all the presets, and you will see all the presets here. Additionally, I have added STXL generation with realism. So when you click direct apply, you will see it. If you don't want realism, just delete this and it will become as expected. So how we are going to use FLUX Kontext? First of all, click quick tools, reset params to default. So everything will be set to default. Then go to this Flux Kontext Dev Edit Images, click here Direct Apply, it will apply all the settings accurately. These models is image editing model with just natural prompts, so we are going to use init image. Click choose file. For example, let's use this image. Image has been uploaded, so the image is ready. Then go to models and you will see Flux Kontext Dev here. This is super crucial. Currently it doesn't recognize its architecture. So click this three hamburger menu, click edit metadata, set the architecture from here FLUX.1 Kontext Dev and then save. After this change you will be ready. The model is by default 1024 to 1024 pixel. You can also increase this if you want. If you want to automatically set the resolutions, it supports a lot of higher resolutions as well. Then click this res and let's use the resolution. So it will use the resolution of my image. However, if your image is really big, what happens? Let me show you. So choose image. Let's choose this. You see, this is a massive image, 4000 pixel. So if I just click res and use the resolution, it will become massive and your computer may crash, it may fail because this is a massive resolution. So what should I do? Click res and use exact aspect ratio. It will set it exactly as your image aspect ratio. You can also use closest aspect ratio, which means that whatever the model supports better, but it also supports exact aspect ratios as well. So the image creativity is one. This really impacts the output you want. Let's try make man has red hair. So the prompting is extremely crucial and you will get used to how to prompt. I am also not an expert yet, but I will show you this prompting is really working good. Like make this, make that. You can also give more details. So let's see the output. Currently it is loading the model. The generation is starting. Currently at my backend, I am using with reverse VRAM 10 gigabytes. So it is not going to fully utilize my GPU at the moment because I'm also recording. Some other things are also working, but the speed is pretty decent. Let's see. Currently it is 1.29 seconds per IT. The seed also matters. Whenever you generate a new image with another seed, it will generate a different image and you may get whatever you want exactly. So the image has been generated and as you can see, it has the perfect quality. Why do I say that? Because I did a lot of research to find the best quality images for you. And let's open the original image. So this is the original image from this image to this image. You see, almost same, almost no changes. It is able to preserve the character details. It still edit the entire image, but it minimally edits the image. The rest of the image, I mean the part that you didn't ask for, it minimally edits it. And this is amazing. This is not like we are using a ControlNet, like a LoRa, whatever. This is a zero shot image editing with just natural prompting and it worked great. So let's see when init image creativity can be useful. Let's say turn this image into anime style image and keep the man facial characteristics as it is. Okay, then let's generate with init image creativity 1 and with like 75 to see the difference. You see, this is like the ChatGPT image editing. This is the anime version of this image with this prompt. When the init image creativity is 1, we can see that from the here. This is with 75, this is with 80, and this is with 85. You see, with 85 we get more resemblance. So it is up to you to decide what kind of init image creativity you want. If you want too much changes, go with it. If you want lesser changes, make this lesser and decide which one is working better for you. So what else we can do? We can also use multiple images interaction. How? Currently, unfortunately, SwarmUI is not supporting multiple image input. So we need to stitch images together ourselves. And for demonstration purposes, I will use these two images. You don't even need to fully make them same size, but if you make them same size, it is better. So let's copy this into here. You can use any image editor you want and merge them like this. So it doesn't have to be perfect, but this is the way it works. So then save it, then load the image from save it file. Like, now this part is extremely crucial. You have to properly prompt it, otherwise it will not work. The prompt matters hugely. So the prompt for this image is place both cute 3D characters together in one scene where they are hugging. Then let's set the image creativity 1, which we want, and generate. Now it will understand that there are two characters in the image and it needs to put them into one scene where they are hugging. You see, this is the natural prompting. Unfortunately, as I said, it is not very easy to prompt. You need to practice, you need to do test experimentation and get used to it. Hopefully I will update the Flux context prompts file as I add more info to it, so you will get most up-to-date version of it. It will be in the zip file, constantly updated. It will give you ideas. Okay, we are getting the result. This is like ChatGPT image editing, but this is more powerful and it is running on your computer. I can just generate 999 images and pick the best one I want. I can change the resolution, increase the resolution. For example, this is the resolution that we got. We can make this resolution bigger. So it is up to us, like res, exact resolution, and it will generate an exact resolution. As the resolution is higher, it will take more time and it will use more VRAM, obviously. But this is a perfect quality image made out of those two images. And I mean, there isn't even anatomical errors. There are two hands with accurate number of fingers. This is just looking really, really good. I mean, really, really good image composition. And this is just random. It is not even cherry picked. And another one is arriving. This is just mind-blowingly good. And here the higher resolution natively generated image, as you are seeing. This is also really, really good quality. So how you can do outpainting? For outpainting, we are going to follow a strategy. The strategy is that adding your image into a bigger canvas. For example, this image is 1216 to 864. I am going to make this image like this. You see? So I will outpaint this area. You can also make it like this, it is up to you, whatever you want. But I'm going to just outpaint this bottom area. So let's just save it like this. You can use any image editor. Unfortunately, there is no easier way yet. Hopefully the SwarmUI developer will make improvements. So choose file, let's choose it. Okay, then the resolution will be exact resolution like this. And I will say that make this image taller. This will outpaint the image we want, and let's see what we are going to get. You see, from this image to this image, and the outpainted image is here. The first try may not be great, so try with different prompting, different seeds. I see that it did expand it more than what we have gave, but it is decent. So this is how the outpainting works. Try and see. So let's also try famous Ghibli style. So click res, use the exact aspect ratio, and let's use this prompt. And let's see what we will get. By the way, these prompts are being added into our Flux context prompts to help you and make your job easier. And yes, we are getting it. How did I get this prompt? I used Grok because it has a lot of data from the Twitter itself. So you can use it to get prompt ideas. And we are getting our image. And let's see. I think it is looking pretty good so far. And it is done. Yes, we turned this image into Ghibli style. And this is our first try. I can generate 100 images and I can decide which one is best. I can change the resolution, make it bigger, whatever I want. If you want to automatically set the resolution, what you should do is edit metadata and let's make this like 1280 to 1280. Save, then click res. Actually, first click here, then click this model, then click res and use exact aspect ratio. And you see, it did set higher resolution with the same aspect ratio. I didn't need to calculate the resolution myself. So you can try this way to generate higher resolution images without calculating manually what you need. Of course, as we increase resolution from its native resolution, which is 1 megapixel, we may get quality degrade, but when we are editing images, it shouldn't be that much obvious. But when you are making a completely new image, it may be more obvious. So you need to test and see if you are liking or not. If you don't like the output, you can always use our super image upscaler, which is the very best image upscaler. From this image to this image with higher resolution, I think the higher resolution is better. Yes, the character is not that great. We should use perhaps a lower threshold. So what about latent upscaling? Let's return back to our original metadata, original resolution, save, let's change the models. Then let's make this use exact aspect ratio, and I'm going to try latent upscale, which is here. Let's make it like this. Since this is an anime image, I'm going to use the real sgran for x anime plus. By the way, we also have upscaler domlas in our dom ladder, which are in the other models and image upscaling models. Just click download all image upscaling models and it will download. So let's make the upscaling 1.5 times. Okay, let's see what we will get. And the latent upscale completed. The quality is magnificent. You are never going to get such quality from the ChatGPT, Gemini, whatever you are using. This is the absolute quality. Let's also try colorizing an older image. So let's use this one, resolution, use the exact aspect ratio. Let's type our prompt. The prompt is also saved in the prompt file. And let's see what we will get. I can see that it is also filling this white area. This is just amazing feature of this Flux Kontext model. And the accuracy is also looking so far great. Let's see until it is finished. I had forgotten to turn off upscale, so I canceled that upscaling. But if you are going to upscale a realistic image, use this model. This is a super realistic upscale model. We can see that it is also filling white area. It is just amazing. And here, wow, wow, just wow. It is looking really, really good. This is the restoration made image. And this was the original image. From this original image, we restored into this image. And this is not even a high resolution image. This is 900 pixels to 580 pixels. This one is 1280 pixels to 832 pixels. So I can say that this is an excellent restored image. Also, if you don't like some part of it, like the perhaps the tongue here, I can just generate more images with different seed and pick the best one I want. So this is all for today. I hope you have enjoyed. If you want to use this model on a private cloud service, I have a very recent tutorial for RunPod, which shows you how to install SwarmUI and ComfyUI backend, or you can use our mass compute image. Our mass compute image already has SwarmUI and ComfyUI automatically installed, so you don't need to do anything. You just need to select from creator, select SE courses, pick your GPU like L40S, apply our coupon SE courses, verify, and just deploy. You see, this is 2 GPU, okay, like this, verify. And L40S GPU is only 65 cents. You can also pick a better one like H100, verify, and it's only $1.76 per hour. You don't even need it. Also, the most price performance GPU is RTX 6080A, verify, and it's only 56 cents per hour. After you connected your mass compute image, just run the stable SwarmUI updater here, then turn it off, then run Cloudflare stable SwarmUI, and you will get a public link which you can use from your computer, from your phone, from your tablet, wherever you want. So stay subscribed, message me from Patreon, leave a reply to this video. Hopefully see you in further amazing tutorials.